Hey, what's good, y'all? I'm Nunu.
And I'm Shangela from RuPaul's Drag Race.
And you're watching One-on-One with Nunu. Nunu. What's good, y'all? Welcome to another exciting episode of One-on-One with Nunu. I do have Shangela from RuPaul Drag Race Season 2 and 3.
Shangela is a comedian, actor, and a fierce drag queen. Shangela LaQuifa Wiley made her television debut on Logo's hit reality show RuPaul Drag Race Season 2, but unfortunately was eliminated. But that didn't stop Shangela.
Hi everybody, welcome to Shangela.com. Hallelujah.
Her hunger, drive, determination, crowning her California Entertainer of the Year in 2010.
And your winner of the very first California Entertainer of the Year, contestant number 8, Shangela!
She appeared in FX series Terriers and performed at national comedy shows with sponsors of BET and Downlink.com. So Shangela pressed on to audition for Drag Race Season 3.
Another year, a new venue. Actually, it's the same old venue, but it's a new audition, a new season, and a brand new Shangela.
And made it. And helped make the show the highest rating season ever. After Drag Race, Shangela is working on acting projects.
While we're here, do you know where we can get some ribs up in this joint?
Touring the nation with live performances and speaking engagements.
Hallelujah!
How long have you been doing drag?
Well, I started performing in drag a little over 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. If anyone watches the second season of RuPaul's Drag Race, you'll see on the first episode, because you know that's about as far as I got on the second season.
Oh, okay.
That I'd only been performing in drag for about 5 months prior to going on the show.
Okay.
So now I've been performing a little over 2 years, and I love it. I think that we're growing, we're learning, and we're continuing to turn the party. Hallelujah.
That's what's up. So from doing season 2 of RuPaul Drag Race, you was only there for one episode.
Yes.
What did you get out of season 2 that made you want to get to season 3?
Well, the great thing is, from being on season 2, when the audition time came around for season 3, mm-hmm. I was like, oh, you know what? I feel that I've grown. I feel, you know, that I have a lot more to share with, you know, America and the fans and Rue that I didn't get to share the first time around. So mm-hmm. I signed up to compete again. I did an audition tape that people can see on funnyordie.com or on my website, Shangela.com.
Okay.
And the producers and Rue felt that I, you know, had grown and deserved an opportunity to come back. So there I was, popping out of that box for season 3.
For season 3. So you had a lot of, what was your best moment of being on season 3 or season 2 of mm-hmm. RuPaul Drag Race? Because I know you had a lot.
Yeah.
Enemies and stuff like that.
I'm a performer. Mm-hmm. I love to entertain. And I think that the great thing, even though it's not fun to be in the bottom two on RuPaul's Drag Race, it was great for me to be able to perform. I had 3 opportunities to really do what I do best, which is perform.
All right.
On the show. And then also on the third season when we did the stand-up comedy challenge. Okay. I really loved that because it allowed me to create the stand-up comedy character of LaQuifa and really turn it out with that. And so I was really happy mm-hmm. with that. And then, you know, recently I just was able to open for Monique, you know, original queen of comedy, actress Oscar winner, Miss Monique.
How did that go?
In Milwaukee at Milwaukee Pride Fest. And it was amazing. She was so sweet and so good to everyone. And I had 20 minutes to really just kill it on stage for her. And so you'll see some LaQuifa projects coming available on iTunes soon for stand-up comedy.
Okay. Shangela LaQuifa Wiley.
Yes.
Tell us about that character, because I know you have a lot of personalities with the drag.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a comedian. Tell us about that. How did you get that name, and you know, where is that character going?
Well, Shangela LaQuifa Wiley, of course, was born here in LA like 2 years ago. I had never performed in drag before. I choreographed a number for these three guys that were doing like a Beyonce single ladies number. And you know, I love me some Beyonce. Shout out Beyonce.
So you're a Beyonce
fan? I'm a Beyonce fan. I love Beyonce fan. Beyonce, I love it. I love her new album.
Okay.
You know, favorite tracks. Let's see. Countdown, End of Time, Run the World.
Okay.
Miss You, I Care. I love One-on-One. Mm-hmm. Party. Okay, yeah. So I like Beyonce.
I'm a Mariah Carey stan. I'm a lamb.
Okay, here he goes.
So compared to Beyonce.
Oh, come on. Beyonce. Okay, give it to the stage. So, we both love Beyonce. Well, I love Beyonce. We both love Mariah. And you know, even I have my Mariah move down.
Okay.
This is my Mariah move right here. See?
Okay.
Mariah makes it rain. Christina fingers it down.
Okay.
That's the way you gotta remember the two. So
what do Beyonce do?
Oh, Beyonce performs. She fall all over the stage like Shangela.
Okay.
Disco.
Wow.
Yeah, wilding out. So, I was choreographing the single ladies number for those guys. One of the guys got sick the night before the show, and they asked me if I could fill in.
Okay.
And from there, Shangela LaQuifa Wiley was born. And actually, I was running late for the club, and they called and they said, they need a name, you know, to put down to introduce you. And I was like, just put something down, I'm on my way, because I never thought it was gonna be something that would be long-term, per se. So, my friends who are, so they're funny too, they got jokes. They put down Shangela LaQuifa Wiley because my friend Brad had worked in telemarketing, and one time he called this lady and he could not get her name right, and she said, let me tell you something, my name is Shangela LaQuifa Wiley, and don't you ever forget it.
So you got that name from a complete stranger.
Yes, she lives somewhere in Connecticut, and hopefully one day I will find her and we will be reunited, and it'll feel so good.
So Miss Wiley was born in LA.
Yes.
So what about you? You from Texas, right?
I'm originally from Paris, Texas.
Paris, Texas.
Now that's the second largest city of Paris in the world. For all y'all travelers out there.
Interesting. So growing up in Texas, have you ever thought, like, as a little boy in Texas?
Yes.
Have you ever dreamed or thought about being a drag queen?
Let me tell you something. I think that I always wanted to be an entertainer.
Mm-hmm.
That's number one. And that's kind of how I classify myself. But I am definitely a drag performer as well. And I love it. Mm-hmm. And there were probably signs that a little Shangela was brewing in there.
Uh-huh.
I did one time in 10th grade, I had this English project for Huckleberry Finn.
Okay.
And so I reworked the words to Tina Turner's Proud Mary, Rolling Down the River.
Mm-hmm.
And I did it as Jim from the book. And so I dressed up as like kind of like a drag runaway slave and performed Rolling Down the River as Jim from the Huckleberry
Finn. And what age were you?
Probably like 16.
Okay.
But I got an A. I got an A plus, and they loved it, and you know, and then I did this.
Did they tip you?
In the classroom? No, that was lunch money. I should go back and get my tips. I did, when we were doing a project on the Holocaust era, there was a lady in Holland named Corrie Ten Boom, and Corrie Ten Boom used to hide a lot of the Jewish people from the Nazis. And so I rewrote for my another English project, I rewrote a song for Corrie Ten Boom, and I dressed up as Corrie Ten Boom in one of my old grandma's dresses.
Mm-hmm.
And I had taken two softballs and put them in a pair of pantyhose and threw them around my neck and hung them like this. And I went to class going, Corrie Ten Boom. I said, a Corrie Ten Boom. A plus. You want an A in English, you do drag. That's what you do.
Yes.
That's what the beginning of the shared.
So being on RuPaul's Drag Race season 3, mm-hmm. you was personal, you talked about, you brought up your grandmother and your family. So how has that relationship been since? For them finding out about you on the show, has it been supportive, or are they looking at you bad? How has that going on?
Well, I'm a big family guy. Okay, I grew up with my mom in Paris, and my mom was in the military, so she traveled a lot, and so I grew up in the household with my grandparents, mm-hmm. my grandma and my grandpa, who I love. And so, you know, for being on the show, they didn't really know about me performing in drag. Like I said, I was only doing it 5 months before going on the second season of Drag Race. And I forgot to tell them that I was gonna be on this national, international television show performing in drag as Shangela. And it wasn't because I was necessarily hiding it, it's just, it wasn't, I wanted to do it in person because, you know, I wanted to explain it to them, and I only get to see them like twice a year. So when I had gone home to tell them before it came on air, like stuff just started happening. Like my great aunt had died, and then my mom was diagnosed with a brain tumor, which she had an operation, she's fine now. But all that just started happening at the same time, and then the next thing you know, I was back to LA, and the next thing you know, the show was coming on, and I had forgotten that I hadn't told my family that I was gonna be on the show. So, you know, people in Paris, because, you know, Paris got television too, started telling my grandma that I was on the show, that I was probably living as a woman. They had rumors going that I was, you know, going to the grocery store during the day with the wig on, you know, just living day to day as a woman. And so that, she didn't know. She was just like, I don't know what's going on. So that definitely forced the conversation, but also it opened the opportunity for the conversation for me to explain, exactly. Like, this is what drag is. And I told her, I said, Graham, you know how, like, you love Mrs. Doubtfire and, like, Eddie Murphy, okay. You know, and Tootsie? She was like, yeah. I was like, well, that's kind of what I do. Like, it's a character for me. So, you know, it's not how I live my day-to-day life, but it's a character. Shangela is a character for me. And she was like, oh. She's like, do you have to wear stockings? You know, stuff like that. And now we talk about it all the time. Like, she'll ask me for lipstick, and she wants to know, like, how the show's went. And I send her, like, little DVDs. Then I have to call and say, Graham, okay, this is how you work your DVD player. You gotta open it. But she watches the show, and she really enjoys it.
That's a good support system, because a lot of people out there is inspired by you, because a lot of them is looking at you as a role model and saying, if Shangela could do it,
yeah,
I could do it too. And probably won't look as good as what Shangela do.
Oh, yes, you can, child, because y'all saw I have grown. I started, you know, when I first started, there's a picture on my website of my very first time in drag. I was doing a play called La Cage here in L.A., and I was Jacob, and then anyone who's seen the play, they know in the second half he's in drag as a maid. And, that picture is rough. Ooh. But from there to now, it just shows you can learn things like makeup. So when you say that, it makes me feel very, you know, very special. But also, I want to continue to represent for those who are starting anything new in your life. And just know that you can definitely learn. You can learn your skills. You can sharpen. You can grow. It all depends on how much work you want to put behind.
Because you have to learn from your own mistakes.
That's right.
To move forward,
exactly.
You know?
And don't give up. No matter what people say, you know. I wasn't always everyone's favorite person, but that doesn't mean that I'm gonna stop my drive, because, you know, I'm living here in LA now. I work as an actor, as an entertainer. I'm touring the country, wanting to meet as many fans as possible as Shangela, performing in nightclubs all the time, and drinking cocktails day and night. Yes, I am. And I love it. So
before we leave,
yes,
we have Samuel from Facebook. He asked you, what are your talents? And I'm gonna add to that too also, other than your talents, what other things are you doing in the future, and what can we expect from you?
Definitely. Well, first, hi, Samuel from Facebook. Thank you for your question. And my talents, well, let's see. I can put down a two-piece and a biscuit from Popeye's like nobody's business on a Tuesday especially. That's a talent of mine. But maybe some other ones. I love performers, stand-up comedy or through whatever. I'm an actor as well here in LA, so I'm continuing to work. I just shot two pilots this season, one for NBC, one for HBO. Hopefully HBO will be picked up for the spring with Sigourney Weaver and Taya Leone. And I'm working. Stand-up comedy is LaQuifa. I've got some new stuff coming out. Check for that on Shangela.com. And just continuing to keep it moving. Hallelujah.
Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you. Thank you. And I want to give a shout out to everyone who's not seen our short film, Body of a Barbie. Check it out, please. It's produced and directed by Lena Waithe, and it's really hot. So check it. Right.
Thank you guys for watching One-on-One with Nunu. This has been One-on-One. Make sure you comment below. Follow Shangela on Twitter.
At It's Shangela, I-T-S Shangela.
Or visit the website, Shangela.com.
.com, hallelujah.
All right. Comment and subscribe. For bios, pictures, and other shows with Nunu,
visit yourboynunu.com.